My name is Victoria Rafalski. I'm a postdoctoral researcher at the Gladstone Institutes in San Francisco, California. We're interested in understanding how the immune system communicates with the brain. Our work has relevance for Alzheimer's disease, multiple sclerosis, brain trauma. So when your head gets hit, you know, in football or something, and then stroke. So when there's clots in the brain. So it's really relevant actually for a lot of neurodegenerative conditions in the brain throughout life, early life, and also aging.
Yeah, I do a lot of microscopy and data analysis.
The mixture, I'm at the bench and I'm also, by the microscope, at the computer. I do a lot of walking around the lab. So it's a very, it's a kind of physical work. Which is great. It's a mix of both sitting down at the computer, but then getting up, and so it's an active kind of job. Yeah, I've always been interested in nature, the natural world. I love plants and animals, and exploring the outdoors. I decided to major in biology when I went to college. Both my parents have PhDs in chemistry, and they continued doing chemistry and then also some biology. So I do have some scientific background. There tends to be a lot of collaborations. But there's definitely times when you are working on your own. That said, you're always kind of surrounded by other people.
Right, more specifically, if you just want the bench, then someone else knows they can maybe use a scope while you're using.
So it's kind of nice to know someone else is there and working hard, and you always have someone you can go and talk to and ask questions or ask for help. Well, I really have a lot of curiosity about why things are the way they are, and I really like that my job enables me to work with my hands and kind of play around all day. It's really fun. There's also a lot of independence. I get to choose what I want to explore and what I find interesting. And then it's, every day is different. There's no monotony. I'm never bored at work. So there's just always something to investigate, problems to deal with. And then I think there's the excitement for potential contribution to society and human health, because our work can relate to human disease and animal disease, and specifically what we're interested in is like the brain and cognitive function and how we can help people to live fulfilling lives in a way that their brain is working properly throughout their life. Science can be hard, but for the most part anything is really achievable, so if you set aside your fears and just go for it, I think you'll be rewarded.